Welcome to my channel Analog Digital Design, and today I am going to discuss about the digital buffer. What is the digital buffer and what is the use of this and how it works. So first, this is the symbol of simple buffer. There are many types of symbol of buffer, but this is the simple buffer. So here generally its output and input is also vary, but this is the symbol of simple buffer. We will study the more buffer symbol and more working principle of the buffers. So here is the features. It isolates the input from the output. Second, providing either no voltage or a voltage that is same as the input voltage. It draws very little current. It does not take so much current. It is also called a unity gain buffer because it provides a gain of 1. Serving no amplification function. It does not amplify the signal. A voltage buffer has a very high input impedance. It has very high input impedance and very low output impedance. A digital buffer is important because it can control the on and off of the data transmission. It can control the input and output because it has the control line here. We will study it in the next slide. The buffer acts as a barrier between the source and load, thus preventing the load resistance affecting the source network. So it also works as a barrier from input, between input and output. So input loading effect does not come to the output and output loading effect does not come to the input. So this is the main work of the buffer. Here we will discuss about the two types of buffer. There are many types of buffer. We will study these in the next slide. So inverting buffer. This kind of buffer produces the output opposite to input. If the input is high, the output is low, and vice versa. Graphically, it is often represented as a triangle with a small circle attaching to the tip. Tip means this. This is the small circuit. This is the called small circuit and bubble also. This is called bubble more. The inverter is a basic building block in a digital electronics. Decoders, state machines, and other sophisticated digital devices may use inverters. This is called inverter also. It is also called inverter. So how it works? If input voltage is 1, input voltage is 1, output will be 0. And if input is 0, output will be 1. So it just reverses the input. Now we talk about the non-inverting buffer. Non-inverting buffer, this is the symbol of non-inverting buffer and this is the symbol of inverting buffer. What is the difference in this? It has bubble and it does not have bubble. So inverting buffer, as a definition, a single input digital buffer is different from an inverter. It does not invert or alter its input signal in any way. It reads an input and output a value. Usually, the input side reads the either high or low input and output a high or low value. Correspondingly, whether the output terminal sends of high or low signal is determined by its input value. The output value will be high if and only if the input value is high. In other words, input is 1, output will be 1. Input is 0, output will be 0. So same thing is here. So this is the non-inverting buffer symbol. So hope friend, you got it. If you got it a little bit, so please like my video, subscribe it, and share it to your friends. In the next slide, we will read and we will study about the tri-state buffer. Tri-state buffer also four types. So in the next slide, we will study about these. Thank you.